The Idolmaster arcade was released in 2005, attracting many arcade goers, and gaining enough positive reception to make Namco realize the success of their own product. This allowed Namco to take the next step in pushing the franchise. Prior to the release of the Idolmaster arcade, the development team had plans for a home release version. It didn't seem likely that the plan would come into fruition, as the strongest console at the time was the original Xbox, which didn't sell well in Japan, and the engine itself was more suited for the PlayStation 2. Plus, the developers would have to completely redesign the game inputs to a controller from a game that is fully played on touchscreen. Essentially, there was no incentive to do all of that effort to bring the Idolmaster to home consoles. However, the situation changed when the Xbox 360 was released, with hardware surpassing that of the arcade and with remarkable online services that would only support the arcade's network mode, which was a core feature that let players compete against each other. This console would be the perfect candidate to port the game, and a chance to garner more customers, as Yozo Sakagami, the game's producer, was told that the Idolmaster arcade was too expensive to appear in some local game centers, or it would be too embarrassing to play in public. Just 7 months after the release of Microsoft's new gaming console, Namco had announced that the Idolmaster will be coming to the Xbox 360. Upon the announcement, screenshots were provided showing major graphical improvements, and also a significant gap between the current and previous generation's hardware. The character models for the 360 were revamped to look more proportionate and modern. The character models in the arcade were much more thick and ragged. These lines were made thinner in the new version. In the first wave of screenshots, an online icon could be seen on the bottom left corner, which the original arcade version also had. In later screenshots, fans noticed that the icon was removed and became concerned about the game being offline only. This would upset many players, since the online auditions were a great way to compete with other players, making it one of the key features of the arcade version. However, the director, Hiroyuki Onoda, assured fans that the game will have an online mode, and only removed the icon since it wasn't really necessary. After all, Namco did choose the Xbox 360 for their well-known history of online support. A few months later, a new character was announced as part of the Xbox 360 version. The cast of 10 idols would receive Miki Hoshi as an additional selectable character. Later in September 2006, the Idolmaster was presented at the Tokyo Game Show convention. Akiko Hasegawa, the voice actor of Miki, had appeared, making her first debut, and it was also introduced as performing Miki's image song, Relations. Go My Way, an original song made for the new game, was also performed by the three hosts, Eriko Nakamura, Imai Asami, and Akiko Hasegawa. Music videos from the game were also shown, showcasing the new and improved visuals. In January 2007, the Idolmaster was finally released for the Xbox 360. As promised, Miki was now a producible idol. The game came with 6 new songs, including Relations and Go My Way, making the total song list up to 16. A new feature was added to check your in-game phone messages from the idols, which is supposed to be a replacement of a very early Idolmaster feature where you linked your actual phone to the web and had the idol send a message to your phone. On the 360 version, you could purchase an email address of any idol from the Xbox Live Marketplace and have them send messages to you on your game phone. As for the actual gameplay, you were no longer playing on touchscreen. Instead, you now use the Xbox 360 controller with the game's UI redesigned to allow players to press buttons more intuitively. In the arcade version, your progress was autosaved, but now you have an option to manually save or continue without saving, allowing you to redo some events in case you make some mistakes. Additionally, the time limit to gain fans was drastically increased to make the game a little more strategic. Voice chat and messaging were also added to online matchmaking during auditions. Overall, this Xbox 360 port feels like an entirely new game. Even though it uses the arcade version as a base, this port was built from scratch on a new engine. The character models ended up being completely redesigned. The motion capture process had to be redone since the arcade could only do up to a maximum of 30 frames per second, while the Xbox 360 was capable of running up to 60 frames per second. The character movements now look more fluid, and even some of the choreography was altered in a few songs. The newer engine also allowed for added stage effects such as smoke and more lighting effects, enhancing the MV experience. The gap in quality is enormous between the two versions, and the gap is only less than 2 years. This port made Idolmaster more accessible and allowed the franchise to gain more popularity, Even more so, with a video sharing site, Nico Nico Doga, beginning to rise in popularity. Fans would record gameplay with a capture card and upload it to the internet, causing the fan base to grow even larger, spawning many memes that became so phenomenal that they found their way into official Idolmaster works.